Hello everyone, I'm Kanchan Khedikar, working as an assistant professor in computer science and engineering department at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today I will discuss IPv4 and IPv6 comparison. So for this, we have some prerequisite. So learners should have good understanding of IPv4 protocol and IPv4 addressing. Learning outcomes: at the end of this session, student will be able to discuss IPv6 protocol and they will compare IPv4 with IPv6. Now let's start with the introduction to IPv6. IPv6 is a new version of internet protocol, which is better than IPv4 in terms of complexity and efficiency. IPv6 is also called IPNG, that means the internet protocol next generation, and it is the newest version of the internet protocol. IPv6 has an address space of 128 bits, or we can say that it is a 16 byte long. The address length in IPv6 is 4 times of the address length of IPv4. Actually, in IPv4, address space is 2^32. Address space means the number of addresses allotted by the protocol. So 2^32 is more than 4 billion. So more than 4 billion addresses are allotted by IPv4. So we can imagine IPv6 allot 2^128 addresses. This shows the IPv6 address space. Now here, total 120 bits are reserved for the addresses. IPv6 has two notations: dotted decimal notation and colon hexadecimal notation. This figure shows dotted decimal notation, which is same as that of the IPv4 dotted decimal notation. IPv6 provide colon hexadecimal notation, which is like this. So here total 8 section, which is separated by the colon special symbol. Now the new term, that is address abbreviation, which is provided by IPv6. IP address in hexadecimal format is very long. Just now we have seen many of the digits are in terms of zeros. So in this case, abbreviation of the address is used. Now in this abbreviation, leading zeros of the sections can be omitted. For example, if the address is 0074, then it is represented as 74. Another example, if address is 00F, then it is represented by F. These three leading zeros are omitted. Similarly, if there is a 0000 in address, then the first three addresses are omitted and only 0 is remain. But note that suppose the address is like 3210, it cannot be abbreviated because there is no any leading zero. The next important topic is zero compression. This zero compression is applied to the colon hexadecimal notation. If there are consecutive sections consist of zeros only, then the zeros are removed and replaced by double semicolon. For example, suppose this is an address which is FDEC colon 4 times zeros, that means the 4 colons or 4 sections are separated by the colons. Then the next is after the colon BBFF and colon 0 colon FFFF. Then such type of addresses are represented by like this. That means here 4 zeros separated by colon is converted into double semicolon. So the address will be FDEC double colon BBFF colon 0 colon FFFF. This is known as zero compression, which is provided by only IPv6 addresses. Now let's see the mixed representation. Mixed representation is nothing but the combination of colon hexadecimal notation and dotted decimal notation. This is appropriated during the transmission period in which an IPv4 address is embedded in an IPv6 address. Now in this mixed representation, colon hex notation for the leftmost 6 section and the dotted decimal notation for the rightmost 4 byte. Now let's see. In this example, these 6 sections are separated by hexadecimal notation, right? That means colon hexadecimal notation. Whereas these four bytes are denoted by dotted decimal notation. So this IPv6 provide the combination of hexadecimal as well as dotted decimal notation, which is known as mixed representation. Suppose these six sections are 00, then this address is represented by double colon, and the remaining rightmost four bytes are as it is. So this is the mixed representation. Now the next topic is CIDR notation. IPv6 uses the hierarchical addressing. Hence, IPv6 allow classless addressing and CIDR notation. CIDR notation, it is classless inter-domain routing. Look at this address, FDEC :// then BBFF:0: FFFF/60, whereas here 60 represent the number of bits present in prefix. Okay, this gives us a number of class or the address. Now this is a question: show the abbreviation for the following address. Total four addresses are given. Now write down the abbreviation of these questions. Abbreviation for the first question is 0:0: FFF:// because here are total five zeros, or the five sections are nothing but the zeros, so that's why the it denoted like :. Then for the next, the solution is 1234:2346:1111. For the next address, the solution is 0:1:1200:1000. For the next D, the solution is :FFFF:24.123.12.6. Now look at the D. This is the combination of colon hexadecimal notation and dotted decimal notation, whereas it is represented in this way. Now let's see a very important topic, that is address space. Address space is nothing but the number of addresses provided by the protocol. So IPv6 provide 2^128 addresses. So it is 2^96 times of the IPv4 addresses. So it is huge. IPv4 provided 2^32. That means what? More than 4 billion address spaces. So we can imagine 2^128 address space, how big number it is. So definitely there is no address depletion problem. Now let's see the difference between IPv4 and IPv6. IPv4 has 32-bit address length. IPv6 has 128-bit address length. In IPv4, address representation is in decimal format. That means we can say the dotted decimal format. But in IPv6, there is the hexadecimal notation format. In IPv4, fragmentation performed by sender and forwarding by the router. Whereas in IPv6, fragmentation is performed by only sender. IPv4 has broadcast message transmission scheme, whereas IPv6 has multicast and anycast message transmission scheme. IPv4 has header of 20 to 60 byte, whereas IPv6 has fixed header of 40 bytes. In IPv4, end-to-end connection integrity is unachievable, whereas in IPv6, end-to-end connection integrity is achievable. Then the last difference: in IPv4, checksum field is available, whereas in IPv6, checksum field is not available. That means in the header format, this checksum field is not available. Now, let's see the benefits of IPv6. IPv6 offers the various improvement over the IPv4. IPv6 is more efficient routing without fragmenting the packet. IPv6 provide the built-in quality of service that distinguishes the delay-sensitive packet. IPv6 eliminates the NAT concept because there is an extension of address space from 32 to 128 bits. It provides the network layer security, which is built in IPv6. IPv6 provide the stateless address auto configuration for easier network administration. IPv6 improve the header structure with the less processing overhead. So in this video, we have studied what actually are IPv6, address space of IPv6, then the comparison of IPv6 with IPv4 and the benefits of IPv6. These are the references. Thank you.